to before, and then you pray that the thing will just stick, because you only have one more shot around this racetrack to win the championship. It will be quite indeed a shootout.
4,300 miles of racing, and we have come down to the final three. Green flag flies. Biffle not slow on the trigger this time. Sprague, Rutman, and then Hornaday.
Watch for some defensive driving now. It looks like Sprague's got a pretty good run going. Biffle takes it to the top and gets the run down the hill, trying to gather speed.
Through turn two, Biffle staying down low. Oh, he wiggles.
Big wiggle. He lost some of the air. Sprague, that little wiggle might have caused him to lift. If he did, Sprague will be. Here comes Hornaday into Rutman.
Hornaday underneath Rutman for third. So now Sprague must win this race.
And it won't make any difference. If he does, he's going to have to get by. And he's trying. He's trying to hit the spoiler. Oh, he doesn't. He gets underneath Biffle right now.
Jack Sprague. Oh, contact. Sprague holds on to the spot. He's got a big donut. One lap to go.
And up in the gray, he's up there throwing a lot of marbles. Right now, Hornaday down. Hornaday can win this race.
Hornaday into second. That would clinch the championship for Ron. Sprague.
And then goes Rutman. Rutman with a big speed as he comes up the racetrack.
A huge crash. Big crash in turn number two, but they will race to the checkered flag because it is behind them. So it is now up to Jack Sprague. He has to hope that Ron Hornaday spins it out. All Hornaday has to do is stay right where he is. It's going to be Sprague's victory.
It's over. This thing's over. This is exactly what they had to do. Ron Hornaday wins the champion. Sprague wins the race.
Sprague wins the race, but Ron Hornaday wins the championship. Listen to that crew.
Oh, man.
Third place will go to Greg Biffle. The two of them salute each other. No one could have written a script better than this. Jack Sprague did everything he had to. Ron Hornaday matched him toe-to-toe.
Biffle got into Sprague. I don't know how he saved that truck. He did. It was a big hit. Fantastic ending to a great year.
As heavyweight championship fights go.
Look at this. Side-by-side for the fans.
That was probably the best heavyweight title fight you could ever dream of. And the emotions. As you see the banner, 1998. Our first two-time Craftsman Truck Series champion. And the name on the trophy will be...
Down
Ron Hornaday.
That's...
Jack Sprague making his way down onto the infield turf.
Well,
so is Ron Hornaday. The two trucks coming side by side, perhaps here. Look at this.
Well, they're both right there past the victory.
What a show of sportsmanship.
High five each other.
The two of them. And the victory donuts for both of them, and they have both earned it. Let's go to Gary Gerald with a man who's got to be just welling with emotion.
Man, I tell you, this is my first truck race. I'm welling with emotion. I can't imagine, Fred, what you're feeling right now. Tell us.
It's just unbelievable. I can't believe it.
Did your heart stop on that last lap?
Oh, absolutely. We just told Ron that if Jack got by Biffle, he had to go with him, and he did it. I can't believe it.
Well, let's go to Victory Lane and watch your guys celebrate.
Unbelievable. Thank you.
His first championship, gentlemen, in all the years.
And I have to tell you, that's a lot of emotion for Fred Graves. He is probably the coolest cucumber on pit lane that you ever want to see. He never gets super high or super low, but I guarantee you, he's super high right now. Stay with us. We will talk to our race winner and our champion when we come back.
Ron Hornaday, for the second time in his career, has got that championship by the throat. He just came out, he jumped on the roof, pushed the toolbox out of the way on the on-truck camera, and now comes down to the back, and boy, you talk about emotion. The man is feeling it. Oh, high fives everywhere. Ron Hornaday, you told us earlier today that having won this deal 2 years ago made it easier. But right now, I'm not convinced that it was any easier. You tell us.
I never said it's been easy. I just said coming into this one, just my mind was set. Thanks. Got to praise the Lord. Man, I don't know who to thank to begin with. This whole Napa Brake Chevrolet team is awesome. And Fred Graves, all these guys that just on this whole team has just got so much faith in me, and I got so much faith in them to come to win this thing. Jack Sprague won the race to come home second. emotional deal, unbelievable.
You were running fourth when Jack was second, battling for the lead, and Jimmy Hensley was right on your back bumper. Now tell us what thought process you were going through with a two-lap shootout as Fred Graves comes in here, and once again the emotion spills over. Tell us about those last two laps.
I'm not telling you about nothing because I don't remember them. All I know is Jack tried to get in front of that 50 truck. The 50 truck hit him. They both lost momentum. I about won the damn race, but you know what? All I do is finish second. When they said I had enough room behind me, I could have probably air loosened Jack and ran into it. But I'll tell you what, we need this championship more than that win. And I'll tell you what, Las Vegas, I finally led a lap here. What an awesome Chevrolet. These guys were just badass all day.
They call him a bulldog, and now we know why. Rick? We are here with Jack Sprague. Jack Sprague, you know you had to give it everything you possibly could. And I got to tell you, in that last lap, you sure did.
Well, we had no choice. We had to win the race. And, you know, I got beside Biffle for the lead, and he just slammed me. And then once I got by him, he moved over and let Ron go. The young man's got a lot to learn. He don't know a whole lot about racing, apparently. But, you know, that's the way it goes. And, you know, the way it looked, if we won the race, we were going to be all right. But he moved over and let him go. You know, I don't understand it. He's going to be in this situation one day, and he don't have a lot of friends as it is. So. But I'm not complaining. I'll tell you, this Team GMAC crew did a great job all year. Appreciate the sponsorship, Team GMAC, AC Protection Plan, Quaker State, Chevrolet, Rotary Lift, Hoss Machinery. Especially like to thank Rick Hendrick. You know, I know he's probably a little dejected right now, as I am. But, you know, we had a great year, 5 wins. And, we knew we had to win the race, and we went after it.
He gave it all he could today. He did at least win the race. Just couldn't quite make that championship.
That's the hardest interview you ever have to do when you do everything that you possibly can and you still come up 3 points short.
Yeah, I've been in a situation like that before. I know exactly what he feels like. You know, tomorrow he'll feel a little bit different. They'll be glad the whole season's over. He has nothing at all to hang his head in shame about. He did everything he could do. His crew did all they could do. Fantastic year for Jack Sprague.
Greg Biffle will be your Cintas Rookie of the Year as he finishes fifth overall. And as we look down through the unofficial results and pick out your favorite driver, we want to thank our crew. I tell you what, they had 40-mile-an-hour winds to deal with today, folks, and the cameras weren't shaking hardly at all. I don't know how they must have super glued their feet to the roof and to all their positions. Great shots, guys. You didn't miss a thing. That was a spectacular race for all of us to be a part of. We hope that you have enjoyed it as well. Here are the final points tabulated. 4,072 for Ron Hornaday, just three back. Jack Sprague, Joe Ruttman solidly in third, Jay Sauter, Tony Rain, Jimmy Hensley, Stacy Compton, and on down the list. Championship coverage next Sunday, Busch Series, Jiffy Lube 300. We'll crown another champion there, 1 o'clock Eastern on ESPN. Then on the November 22nd, the Dash Series and the All-Pro Series. For Dorsey Schrader, Rick DeBruhl, Gary Gerald, I'm Marty Reed. Thanks so much. This has been an ESPN presentation, a worldwide leader in sports.